Welcome back to Clear Cut. A warning for Israel from an influential American. The state is losing touch with young American Jews. In an interview with Haaretz this week, Alan Hoffman, the CEO of the Jewish Agency, called the trend extremely worrisome. Last year, the brand, Israel Group, released a survey showing Israel's favorability among young Jewish American college students dropped 27 percentage points between 2010 and 2016. One young American Jew with some strong views on this is Adam Friedland. He's a millennial activist who is also a stand-up comedian, and he's here in studio with me tonight. Adam, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Does that surprise you that more young American Jews are losing touch with Israel?
No, I mean, it makes sense in the context of Trump in the last year. He's not very popular, and I think the rise of the alt-right and the rise of individuals in the states that are arguing for an ethnocracy here has made young Jews question whether an ethnocracy, a Jewish ethnocracy in the Middle East, is a moral, is morally sound. So I think that's probably it probably makes sense because of how unpopular Trump is with the majority of young Jews in this country.
But is that fair? Just because Trump likes Israel, American Jews who are Democrats can't like Israel? And
no, I don't think that's the issue.
Just one more thing. Yeah. The other point, people in Israel would say they're not, a pure state. 20% are Israeli Arabs. There's also Black Jews there. So when Richard Spencer says we like Israel, he doesn't know what he's talking about, right?
No, I mean, I think that still when you see the amount of funds that are allotted to Arab-Israeli communities in Israel proper. I mean, there's a huge disparity between that and Jewish communities in Israel proper. Second of all, you see the decision now of the Israeli government to imprison and deport African refugees in Israel. We have similar issues here in the United States with refugees. I mean, last week Trump called many people from Central America and Haiti, people coming from shithole countries. So it's similar challenges. I mean, I think the wall, for instance, is another similarity. This is kind of something that a lot of people are against. A lot of liberal Jews are against in the United States. But then we can see that it's been implemented in Israel itself. So there's sort of kind of we're now seeing some sort of overlap occur. And
I hear what you're saying. I'm just wondering, I think people in Israel would push back on the wall because it was put in place because there were a lot of Palestinian terror attacks. So it was a security thing. It wasn't keep them out as much as protect Jews in Israel. But again, do you think there's anything to be done to get, because people can be critical of Israel. I think if a place that you love, you should be critical of it. You want it to make it better. Do you think that young American Jews should be feeling like they want to fight to make Israel better? Or are you just seeing them want to disconnect from the country?
I think people are kind of exhausted at this point because there's so many problems in the States right now. I think the American Jews, our parents seem to be a lot more passionate. Their generation were a lot more passionate. I think we're facing our own challenges in this country, and I think that's actually kind of positive. American Jews for a long time have felt like they were maybe in control or had some sort of say in what was happening in another country that wasn't theirs, that they weren't paying taxes. They obviously supported, and I think that to some extent they extended a conflict that was dangerous, and I don't think that they had a full and clear grasp on the fact that people were dying on both sides, Israeli young people and Palestinian young people. So, I mean, I think that was a dangerous trend that existed in our parents' generation. I think nowadays, what's pretty much happened is that we're scared in this country because there are people that are arguing for an ethno-state. There are Nazis marching in Charlottesville, for instance.
So I just want to stop you there.
Yeah.
So the reason that Jews in America have loved Israel so much is because for thousands of years, Jews were persecuted all around the world, to have a Jewish homeland mm-hmm. where they could feel protected and safe and connected to that. That mm-hmm. was the reason they loved it. So when you talk about a rise of the alt-right and Nazis wanting to get rid of Jews in America, mm-hmm. there's a reason that Jews love Israel, because it's their state. So at the end of the day, they have a place that they're, it's their ancestral homeland. It's the country that they belong to. Do you understand that
I understand
part?
That too, but then I also understand that Benjamin Netanyahu's son was sharing alt-right memes on his own Instagram account. He was blaming Black Lives Matter activists for the violence in Charlottesville. So it's kind of strange bedfellows that have occurred, that have like come up in the last year, is that the far right in the United States has sort of like their messaging, I guess, has sort of mirrored the alt-right and the far right in the United States, and it doesn't make it palatable to a lot of Jews, young Jews in the States.
I won't argue with that. I will say that it's not everyone in Israel. It's a, you know, some people in the government. But this was a great conversation.
Thank
I'm glad
you.
We had you on. Thanks again, Adam.
I don't know if I'm an activist. Also.
Whatever, comedian. We'll call you a comedian. There
yeah.
you go.
Hometown. Yeah.
All right, next time you'll tell us some jokes.
I will, yeah.
All right, still ahead. Forced to step down, the anti-Israeli tweets that led a L'Oreal model to resign. We will show you that story after the break. Stick around.